Hello, welcome. Thank you so much for joining us today. We're so happy you could be here. My name is Tom Ollerton and I am your host this afternoon. Today is a very exciting day for skiers all over the world. This afternoon, KJUS will launch a brand new innovative product that will literally change the future of ski wear forever. KJUS are a Swiss sportswear brand that were co-founded and named after Lasse KJUS, the Norwegian Olympic skiing legend. And for the last 18 years, KJUS have been delivering innovative, premium, performance-enhancing sportswear. And today is absolutely no different. What we're going to see is a world first in the world of ski wear, and you people are going to be the first ones to see it. So that's really exciting. But before I hand over to our panel, I just want you guys to notice that you can ask us questions. So on the screen that you're looking at, there should be a box where you can type in questions and that will come straight through to me here. Or actually, you can also email in questions about the product to media@shoes.com. So let's get on with it. So hi guys, how are you?
Fine, thank you.
So we have Ken Kurtzberg, who's the head of innovation at KJUS, and we have Joachim Holter, MD and chairman of Osmotex. So thanks for being here today, guys. So Ken, big day.
Yes.
You guys have reinvented ski wear again. Tell us what you are launching.
We're launching the 7-sphere Hydrobot ski jacket. It's a jacket that will change waterproof, breathable industry in the future. It works, it monitors your sweat at the push of a button.
Right, okay, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So that sounds complicated, sounds like very innovative, but what problem is that actually solving for a skier like me?
Well, to start with, very simply, what it does is it brings moisture from the inside to the outside of the jacket electronically, very fast, and keeps you dry over the entire ski day. The problem that it attacks is a huge industry problem called breathability. We call them waterproof breathable jackets. Waterproof comes first, and breathability is pretty far down the line. And we've looked at this for quite a long time, especially in ski wear. Ski wear, we're dealing with snow, so frozen water. So the breathability is more in the front. And about 8 years ago, we started testing with an institute called EMPA in Switzerland. And we did some benchmarking and to try to find ways of how to improve breathability in ski wear jackets. And we developed two quite very high functionality technologies. One is called AC Vent. It's located on the bottom of your arm and very simply works the way your body works. So your body cools itself by pumping warm blood to its extremities. It's like pulling up your sleeve and allowing the warm blood to cool itself. The second technology is 7-sphere. That's where also Hydrobot has its name because it fits in that family. 7-sphere is a layering system. So it allows you from the temperatures of plus 10 degrees to minus 20 degrees to dress perfectly for different ski conditions. And that reduces the amount of sweat that is generated. Talking about sweat, you're going to ask how much sweat do we actually have, and that's represented in the bottles here.
Wow.
We calculate based on our testing that you sweat about 60 milliliters per hour, and if you ski 6 hours per day, that's 3.6 liters.
And that's this much.
And that's a day. This much of wow. moisture in a normal ski day for an average person. And you have to imagine that all this liquid has to go somewhere.
Okay.
And very often it gets trapped inside your jacket and it doesn't get released. And what happens there, if you're cold, you're chilled, and you don't have a very nice skiing experience.
And so what does that do to the skier's performance? Does it enhance performance anyway, or is it just comfort?
Interesting question. We think of comfort very much as, yeah, it's kind of cozy and warm. But comfort is a little bit more. If your body is comfortable, that means your core temperature, which is 37.5 degrees, is in equilibrium. And when that happens, your body doesn't have to work so hard to manage its climate on the inside. But take yourself, put yourself in a tropical environment. It's 40 degrees outside. You're very hot, you're sweating. How do you feel normally? You feel a little lethargic, not really very motivated to ski at 40 degrees, obviously, but not motivated to do very much. So put yourself in an environment where you're comfortable, you feel good, your energy level goes up. And essentially what's happening is that your body has to use less energy to manage itself and can use more energy to do whatever you want to do on skiing in this case.
So this technology takes the moisture from your skin and sends it out to the outside of the jacket. But I'm assuming that other products do it, but does this do it quicker?
It's very quick, actually. But it's very hard to compare. It's very different systems. We call it an active system versus a current traditional membranes are more of a passive system. And this passive system, you need a lot of moisture and warmth to build up on the inside of the jacket, and then it slowly moves to the outside. And Hydrobot on the other side is an active system. So immediately, the moment you sweat, it is moving moisture out. And we feel it's hard to compare, but it's at least 10 times faster than a normal membrane. And the cool thing about it, it sweats with you. So if you're sweating at a low amount, it's pulling that moisture out. If you're sweating at a very high amount, it's also moving. So the more you sweat, the faster it works.
And is that true for all temperatures? Does it matter how cold it is outside? Or is it dependent on factors like that?
Yes, that's actually one of the reasons Hydrobot was very interesting for us, because passive membranes are normally tested in the lab at about 30 degrees. And have a nice performance, but as soon as you go 5 degrees and lower, their performance goes down about 50%. So it loses a lot of the functionality of what it can do. So Hydrobot is not temperature sensitive at all. It works at high temperatures and low temperatures. And we've seen that in some of the testing we've done, which we'll talk about in a minute.
So that's great to know that the colder it is, the better the tech is, but can we look at how the technology is actually integrated into the jacket. So if we can have the first model on, thank you. Can you just go into a bit of detail about how the product works?
Sure, here it is, the first Hydrobot jacket we're proud to see in front of us. The jacket itself is made from a shoulder fabric with a seat change membrane to support the functionality of the Hydrobot. The Hydrobot panels are located on the back. Boris, if you just have a turn around. You see two panels on the back of the jacket, and those are the Hydrobot panels in the jacket itself. Okay. But to better understand it, I think it would be easier if we look on the inside of the jacket, if we can just do that.
So this is the jacket inside out, reference.
The jacket inside out, and if we turn around, we can see the back side of the jacket. You see the two black panels on the back side of the jacket. They're linked through a wire on the front. They're taped and sealed into the jacket itself. And on the front of the jacket, if you turn around, there's a small control box. On this control box, there is a button that turns the jacket on, off, and places it into a standby mode. So with that, you can control the functionality of the Hydrobot system. The jacket can also be charged directly through the jacket itself. Put the control bar back in. Then on the bottom of the jacket, there is a small cable in a pocket. And this can be charged. It's a normal USB charging. You can have it charged with a power pack. Makes it very flexible. Or any other USB charging device.
And we were chatting earlier that there's also an app on iOS and the Google Play Store, is
yes,
that right?
Yes, to add a bit more comfort to it and to enhance the experience of Hydrobot, we've developed a specific app that has the same features, turns Hydrobot on, turns it off, has a lot of information about the system, carrier instructions, and so on. But more importantly, we've developed a very interesting tool called a sweat monitor. The sweat monitor, you can see directly on the app just to what degree you're sweating. So the panels are picking up moisture from your body, translating that into a level of low, medium to high. On a low scale, everything is fine, don't need to do anything, but on a medium scale, your sweating is starting to increase. So it would recommend to open up a vent, the AC vent, for example. On a high level, it would even recommend to remove a layer. So with those functionalities, you can, because it's always hard to see what's going on inside of the jacket. You're enjoying the ski day, you're having fun, you're going full speed. Sometimes you forget about your climate. So this gives you a little bit of a heads up of what's going on. And by doing this, you're sweating less. When you're sweating less, you have more energy to ski and increases your performance.
Joachim, Osmotex, your business, makes the panels and the control box. And as I understand it, it uses a technology called electroosmosis, which sounds really fancy, but could you just explain that to me? What is that? How does it work?
Well, osmosis in nature is the movement of liquid molecules, molecules from one side of a membrane to another. The base for electroosmosis is that we take a special textile membrane. We charge it with a small electrical pulse, so we transform the membrane itself into a set of micro pumps. With these micro pumps, we're able to transport huge amounts of moisture, and when we then put these textiles into a ski jacket, we're able to remove the excess moisture from the inside of the jacket, keeping the skier dry and comfortable.
So this sounds like incredible technology. Is this something you developed recently, or did it take a while to arrive at this point?
Just like KJUS, we've been keeping this up for about 20 years, and we also have Norwegian roots. But Osmotex is a Swiss company, and over the last decade, we have been doing extensive lab research at our own facility on the field of electroosmosis. Over the last 3 years, we have been focusing on the product Hydrobot in cooperation and close cooperation with KJUS, with Scholler Textile, and with the institute mentioned EMPA. We have then moved also the experiments from our lab and into simulation of real conditions at EMPA in climate chambers and with sweating dummies. Additionally, we've been doing field tests. From Osmotex side, we've been doing field tests with the KJUS jacket, doing cross-country skiing. This is a high cardio, high sweat activity, proving that we are able to, the more you sweat, the faster our system works. And of course, KJUS has done some field testing as well.
Exactly, yeah. We've done a lot of field testing last winter, almost 6 weeks of testing from December through the end of January. And in that testing, we had used the Austrian Ski Academy, skiers that ski pretty hardcore and very intense. And we got a lot of interesting feedback on it. But one of the biggest statements was just the difference in perception and feel of the jacket. The skiers said that they felt that the beginning of the run and after the run almost the same, that there is almost no change. Normally it would come down after a ski run and then open the jacket up a bit before getting on the lift. Here they just left the jacket closed.
So this is amazing technology. I'm sold. So is there any other use of this technology? Is this going to be used for different sports, different occasions? How is this going to change the future of outerwear?
Absolutely. I mean, we're just at the tip of the iceberg for this technology. Anything where there's a waterproof, breathable technology or weather protection technology, Hydrobot can be applied, and we see a wide range of uses here in addition to ski wear.
Yeah, and obviously you can use it in all kinds of activities, whether it's sports or work, all activities where you do sweat, that where you need to have moisture removed. And also this technology, it's a low energy moisture management technology, which is quite a new thing in various industries. So the scope of where we can make use of the Hydrobot technology is quite huge.
Right, so I'm convinced. Can I get one for Christmas?
Sure. That's
a big question. Okay.
Yes,
how convenient. Tell me about that.
Just in time, actually. We have actually a limited number, but we're going to start selling it as the 10th of December. And I would say be quick. We have offer the option to reserve the jacket online as of the 22nd of November. So if you place your order quickly, you have a good chance of getting it
before Christmas. That is good to know. So thanks, guys. We've been getting some questions from the website, but also through email. So hold on to your seats. This is going to get quite tricky.
Okay.
A few people have asked. So brilliant technology, but there's electronics in it. Does that mean you can't wash the jacket?
That's a good question. Actually, the jacket is designed to be washable. We have that from the start. It's a feature with all of our jackets. That can be done very simply in the jacket itself. If you remove the control module from the jacket, and then it can be washed normally in a gentle wash cycle.
And another practical question. Can you tell us about how durable it is in terms of like folding and friction force? Is it going to last over time? Like how durable is it?
That was important for us as well. So that's why we did a 6-week, which is a long testing period, in which the jackets were washed on a weekly basis. We try to simulate a long-term usage of the jacket. And really try to, try to destroy the panels themselves. We were not successful.
Okay, good to know. You'd be interested to know that question came from the Hanoi University of Science and Technology.
Okay,
so
wow.
We're getting out there
good
already.
Question.
So it's got a battery. How long does that battery last? Am I going to have to charge this every time I do a run, or does it last longer than that?
Depends how much you sweat. No, the battery is actually lasts for 16 hours as a minimum, but might most likely last longer. Batteries are a bit sensitive to cold conditions, but although this is on the inside of the jacket, so we estimate 16 to 20 hours, and then charging time is about 45 minutes to an hour, so it's quite quick. And with a USB charger, you're quite flexible. And in worst case conditions, you can bring your own charger with you.
Just to fill in there, I've been using it for in sub-zero 20 degrees Celsius for two ski days. So that's kind of 16 hours in 20 degrees minus. So it's durable.
It's hardcore.
Yeah.
So how important is it what you wear underneath the jacket? Can you get away with just a t-shirt, or what do you recommend? Does it change what you have to wear underneath?
Very, very critical question. Very good. What you wear underneath dramatically influences the entire climate of what you're wearing. And Hydrobot works with sweat, but if you lock yourself up and don't allow sweat to get to it, that's actually a problem. So we recommend wearing anything knit related that allows moisture to pass through very quickly. Anything air permeable works very, very good in the back. And ideally, the Hydrobot jacket is part of a range called Seven Sphere. Any of the elements in the KJUS Seven Sphere line would fit perfectly with the jacket.
So it sounds like the perfect product for keeping you warm and dry. That's lovely. But to a amateur skier or someone that's just starting skiing, is this for them or is this just for the pros?
Good question. If we think back a little bit, when we first learned to ski, some of them were small of us, some of them were a little bit older. When you first learn to ski, you almost sweat more than when you're actually better at skiing. It has to do with this falling down and getting up a lot. So actually for a beginner skier, it's ideal. It's perfect because it actually starts working very, very fast. And we see Hydrobot for beginner to a more advanced skier. Everybody would have benefits from it.
So will this work when wearing a backpack?
It actually works better with a backpack. We've seen in some tests by chance. The more contact, and I think you've seen that in cross-country mm-hmm. skiing, the more contact, the closer it is to the skin, the faster Hydrobot works. So if we have less layers and they're reduced or pushed onto the Hydrobot panel through the backpack, we see even increased transfer of moisture.
And will it still work if the technology is turned off? If it's run out of battery or you forget to turn it on, are you going to be cold or does it still work?
It still works, but then it transfers itself from a active functionality more to a passive membrane, so more traditional membrane. You still have a Schuller seat change membrane in the entire jacket, so it just shifts its level of performance, but it still works as a normal ski jacket.
So, important question, is this going to be in all of your jackets from this point forward?
I think it is a future technology. Right now it is in the highest level jacket that we have in the line. And normally we will trickle down technology into other products. So we need to see in the future, but it will definitely increase its presence in the line in the future.
Okay, great. Thank you guys. It's been a real privilege to be part of this launch. The technology does sound fantastic, and I will gladly accept a jacket as a Christmas present from either of you. So, thank you so much, and thanks for everyone who have joined us today online. Thanks.